Ah, yeah, of course. Napoleon's willow. So back late 1800s rather, a French sailor came over to New Zealand, took a couple of clippings from Napoleon's famous willow tree, the one that stands beside his grave, the island of St. Helena in France. One here to Christchurch, one more planted in the gardens, a couple more further down the street. Victoria Square in the city, a couple more of Napoleon's willow trees. Some of the first willows to make the way here to the south island. Early days of Victorian punting boat. Hustle and bustle of Victorian England around about 1850 or so when the first punts started popping up. Literally were boats used for carting cargo up and down the shallow rivers over in England. That was the case for about 50 years or so. In 1901, when Edward came to rule over England, the Edwardian era that stretched from about 1890 to 1914 in the start of World War I. Quite a short era in the grand scheme of things, but a rather comforting find. Leisurely in the Victorian era before it. Around that time, people started taking out the cargo, putting into the fancy seats, flush with them, into the punty, and they came up to pleasure punting. You find yourself all on today. It was very popular back then. These punters were really Edwardian style of boating. It was in fashion. Pleasure punting was in its height of popularity. These days, it's more of a rare form of fashion. The punters themselves as well, quite a rare form of transport. The Avon, the only place you can find this style of boat in New Zealand, Christchurch. It's probably the most Anglo-centric or English-influenced city around the country. Most of the pubs these days are associated both with Oxford and Cambridge, especially over in England, where they originated from. The main pub, it's a little bit of an oxen. It derives from an old Latin word, pont, which means the bridge or the cross. Of California people, most of the streets in the world. direction. I find my way mainly based off sense of movement. The main current having away, there's a couple of brown trout, the rainbow trout as well. There are some other smaller species of fish here and there as well, which seems to out on some parts of the river, but here through the Botanic Gardens of the central city. Around the place, but they're pretty crafty. The spot about 20 kilometres behind us, and the river meets the sea, the estuary is home to several flounder. There you'll see the gum tree. A little bit concerning there. Over there, that's going to mark the pathway of our journey. So we'll turn around shortly, coming our way back down towards the boat sheds again, because punting boats were built to facilitate